On behalf of Bishop Bobby and Dr. Valda Hilton and the Word of Deliverance Ministerial Fellowship International, we welcome you to Holy Convocation 2019. Our theme for this year is Well Done, Good and Faithful Servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord. This evening's speaker is Pastor Kimberly Ray Gavin of Madison, Illinois, with a word of encouragement for the people of God.
Yes, there were He turned it. He turned it. He turned it. If he turned anything for you, hit about five folks telling me, turned it. My, 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 my. I need some church folk to put your hands together and give this God a praise. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you just don't know. Say, neighbor, you just don't know. Tell him, I don't look what I've been through. I don't look like what I've been through. He turned it. Everyone stand. Ah, cholo casa. Everyone standing, please. Tonight. It is our humbled honor to bring forth in holy convocation 2019 an anointed vessel that some of us see and meet in this particular setting for the very first time. Although it is her first time here, in absolutely no way is she a stranger. When I looked at her, I said, I can feel it. We have the same DNA. Your daddy, my daddy, they daddy. This anointed woman of God is
one of four evangelistic daughters of the late blessed Dr. Angie Ray, incomparable founder of Angie Ray Ministries in Madison, Illinois. Pastor Kimberly Ray Gavin is a woman after God's own heart, seeking to lead the people of God by providing effective strategies and tools to empower the church to be efficient in the ministry of intercession and deliverance. Anything, anybody know anything about that time of intercession? With Dr. Angie Ray, y'all better come on here. Throughout her 31 years of ministry, Kimberly's passion for God and surrendered lifestyle has graced her with an anointed preach and teach word of God with authority, revelation, and deliverance. Kimberly serves as senior pastor and currently produces the internationally televised program, A Time of Intercession. Viewed on the Word Network in over 200 countries and local stations, she has been called by her peers a standard bearer, a feminine warrior in the gospel, and a young woman with an old mantle. Where did she get that from? Pastor Kimberly's fiery style and charisma are inscribed in all of her endeavors. Above all, her love for the Lord Jesus Christ and for humanity. It is constant and exceedingly great. It is my humble honor to present to some, introduce to all of you, an anointed, mighty warrior woman of God. I need you to put those God-blessed hands together and let us welcome the Holy Convocation 2019, Pastor Kimberly Ray Gavin. Come up.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Let us have a word of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we honor you and we bless your name. And Lord, we come humbly before you tonight and we ask that you will move by your power and by your spirit. Father, we need you tonight. We need you to visit us and to touch us, Father. And Lord, we ask you in the name of Jesus to have thine own way. Let the glory of the Lord be revealed in this place. Lord, bless every servant of God tonight, every soldier, those that have been serving in the household of faith. I ask God for a special miracle, a special touch for those that have been diligent in your house. Breathe upon them tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you because you've been good to us. All of our lives, you've been good. And down through the years, you've been good. And so God, we just want to take a moment and just say thank you, Lord. As we look back over our lives, we bless you because, God, you have been just, you've been there for us, and we honor you tonight. Have your way, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, take our hearts and mold them. Take our minds and transform them. Take our wills and conform them, God, to thine own will. And, Father, we'll give you all of the glory and all of the honor. All of the praise shall be thine forever. Move in the midst of thy people. And we thank you for what you're about to do tonight. And it is in the matchless name of Jesus we pray. Let the church say amen. Let us say amen again. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of God. First and foremost, I want to honor the Lord for being here tonight. I am so grateful for such a lovely and gracious introduction. So kind. Amen. And I want to just take a moment and ask all of you all to celebrate the visionary of this conference and convocation, this mighty vessel of God. If you love your bishop, will you put your hands together for Bishop Bobby Hilton tonight? Praise the Lord. If you love him, make him feel it. Amen. and to his precious wife. Give the Lord a wonderful praise for Dr. Hilton as well. Praise the Lord. They have both been so hospitable and kind to us since our arrival here tonight. I also want to take a moment and celebrate a man of God that I have had an opportunity to meet personally, and I consider him arguably one of the greatest voices in the earth today. I am talking about the profound and prolific man of God. Will you clap your hands for Bishop Michael Blue? That's my big brother. And he has a most gracious wife who's a power-packed soldier. Put your hands together for First Lady Melinda Blue. I love you. Praise the Lord. To all of the pastors and the College of Bishops, I honor you respectfully, each and every one of you in your places. Amen. We also want to thank God for those church mothers, amen, that have been acknowledged earlier tonight. I want to just take a moment and give God great applause for the mothers in Zion. Amen. Let's give God a praise for that. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We honor each of you and your investment into the kingdom of God. I have with me my baby sister, and her name is Tanya. And I'm just going to ask Tanya to just sing just a verse of something. And then we're going to go into the word of God. Amen. Tanya and I got saved the same night. She was 8 and I was 10. And we've been serving the Lord together. Will you welcome my sister, Sister Tanya?
My soul loves Jesus. My soul loves Jesus.
Your soul loves Jesus. Will you put your hands together and give him a glorious praise? Come on, church. Hallelujah. Can anybody in the house give God a high praise? If your soul loves him, come on, give him glory and bless his name. Amen. It is in him that we live and move and have our being. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. It is a distinct pleasure and honor to stand before you tonight to express what the Lord has placed on our hearts. I want to just share with you all something just before we go into the reading of the Word of God together. I want to give God the glory that several months back, actually it was in last year, the Holy Spirit just quickened me to go and to sit still and just write. And the Lord began to deal with me about the hearts of the saints of God. And I wrote a book entitled The Heart Monitor. Amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you. And the Heart Monitor is a 30-day evaluation of the heart. It's 30 different subjects about the status of your heart in light of the scripture. We have written about the upright heart, the clean heart, the contrite heart, the jealous heart, the bitter heart. We've been reading and writing about those are the things that the Lord gave me to write. And so I've penned it in book form, and I just want to share with all of you all that I believe that this is the hour that we must have something called introspection, where we look and see where we really are. Amen. And I would like to tell you all about that. We'll be at the book table after service. And I just want to share with you all, I pray that you will be blessed by the heart monitor. In the natural, you know, in the natural, when you go to the doctor, they place leads and cables to the human body, and it gives you an indication of what's going on internally. It shows you your blood pressure. It shows you the heart monitor machine. It also indicates if there is a, if the rhythm of your heart is too fast or too slow. And it gives the doctors the ability to treat whatever is happening. And so it is in the spirit. Some of us need God to go into our hearts, amen, and cleanse us and purify us. And so I wanted to share that with you all. And then there is another publication I must share with you all about. It's called Spiritual Intervention. And it's a book of prayers. And some of you know that in the natural, that's if a person has a person in their family that might be on drugs or have some kind of addiction, usually the whole family will come together and they will have a meeting with that person and try to stage an intervention, right? That's in the natural. Amen. But I want you to know when you've got the Holy Ghost and you have the power of prayer, that your prayers can stage an intervention. Amen. And so whatever is going on with a person in your family, God has given you the power to address it, to speak to it, and it has to change. And I thank God for that. Lastly, there's a book called The Prevailing Prayers of the Bible. I was blessed to travel to Israel, and I remember standing in front of the Wailing Wall. And remember just the sound that I heard and the feeling that I heard. And I just, when I came home, had a desire to write the prayers that I found in the Word of God. How many of you know that Hannah had a specific prayer? She prayed. She wanted a son, right? Amen. And God heard her and honored her. So this book, basically most of the prayers in the Bible, you'll find it in the Prevailing Prayers book. And I want to thank God for that. And lastly, I want to thank God for two young ladies that got on the road this morning to come and be with their pastor, Sister LaShonda and Sister Alexia. Would y'all wave at them? They're back there in the back. Thank God for them being with us tonight. Praise the name of the Lord. Well, I love you all with the love of Christ, and I just want to give you all a little bit of what the Lord has been speaking to my spirit, and I just know for sure that there's something that God revealed to me during our 20, we were on a 20-day fast at the beginning of the year, and as we were fasting, the Lord began to reveal something to me about the church, about the saints of God, and I want to share with you all this, that the Lord revealed to me as we were praying and in times of fasting and prayer that this is a year that He is going to reward the faithfulness of God's faithful people. And this is a year that you're going to experience the repayment of the investments and the sacrifices that you have made. And I'm talking about you're going to see it with your own eyes, the rewards for being faithful in the house of God. Now, if you've been really faithful, I'm talking about those of you that have been dedicated and committed, you are the first in line for this miracle. You might be an usher, a deacon, a trustee, doesn't matter. You are going to receive the benefits of being faithful. Now, if that's not going to make you happy if you've not been faithful. But if you've been faithful to some capacity of the church, can I ask you, what area of the church have you been serving in? Ask your neighbor, what have you been serving in? What have you been serving in? All right. Now, if they told you they've been serving in something, amen, and they've been diligent and faithful, I want both of y'all to give God the glory for what God is about to do. If you've been faithful, I need you to give God the glory. Because God spoke to me and said, this is the season and the hour for the faithful people of God. Amen. If you've been dedicated, faithful, faithful to ministry, faithful to service, there is an outstanding, overwhelming outpour that is about to happen in your life. Okay, y'all give Him the praise for that. I felt this way one day, and I'm going to go to the scripture, but there was a woman in our service at our church. And the Lord revealed to me, this woman of God had been saved for years and years and years and years, holy woman of God. The Lord gave me to tell her one thing, to tell her that there was a glass ceiling, and that's what, the way I saw it, a spirit like hindering, delaying, blocking, impeding what God wants to do for her, right? And the Lord told me to tell her in the service, I want you to give God the praise. And while you're praising God, he's going to break this thing that has been blocking something that's trying to get to you. That woman of God did not look around and wait for nobody to tell her how to shout and what to do. She praised God out of her soul with her whole heart. In 3 days, and I don't have to exaggerate, in 3 days, this woman of God was located by the people that were trying to find her. Her late husband passed away as a result of a mistake that was made. And they had to find her to give her the proceeds of what belonged to her late husband. She got the first check in 3 days for $52,000. I'm trying to get you all to catch something. If you have been faithful to God, he's getting ready to break the hindrance, the delay, the thing that's blocking the blessing. God is getting ready to bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That woman of God now receives a check every month until her death in repayment for what happened to her late husband. I just want to tell you all that when God speaks a word to you, you can believe it. You can trust that what he said, he's going to bring it to pass. I just want to tell you, I've seen him work. And I know that there's nothing too hard for God. Somebody put your hands together. We're going to Psalm 139 and verse 23. And I just want to share with you all what the Lord just, I mean, he placed this so deep in my soul for the saints that are in this house tonight. Amen. Psalm 139, we're reading a hymn psalm of David. David that wrote this particular Psalm 139 and verse 23. It simply says, and remember, this is a psalm attributed to David. He said, search me. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. And see if there be any wicked way in me. And Lord, and lead me in the way everlasting. I want to share with you all today, amen, that this is an hour that it is necessary that as a people of God that we remember that one day each of us must stand before the Lord to give an account for the deeds that we have done in this body. And I believe with all of my heart that in this particular case that David was reaching out to God and asking of him, Lord, search me and show me whatever that is in this heart of mine that should not be there. He began to let God know that I don't want any sin in my life, either sin of omission or sin of commission. I don't want to sin against you. So Lord, I'm going to stand before you right now and I want you to search my heart. I want to share with you all, beautiful people of God, that your heart is your center. The heart is actually the core of your existence, your soul. The heart is the seat of your emotions. It is the place where speech and thought and conduct emanate from. And so when you deal with the heart, it is the essence of who you are. It's your authentic self. And so many times when you hear sermons, it's like it's easy to assume what's going on in the heart of somebody else. But tonight, I need you to deal with what's going on in your heart. I want to talk to you tonight about the fact that sometimes in life, life has a way of crushing you. And if you go through the storm long enough, It can affect how you begin to treat other people. Even though you're saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost, there are times when people who are low down and miserable and evil will try to work the very last nerve you have. But you've got to give an account for how you deal with what's going on in your heart. The Lord began to deal with me. Many of us on the outside, we're looking all right and we're doing well, but He wants to know what's going on the inside. So remember, your heart is your center. It denotes your emotional and intellectual activity. Your heart is the seat of your soul. It's the core of who you are. It's what you really feel. It's what you really think. It's not something that what it looks like on the outside, but it's the part of you that's the real you. Tell your neighbor, your real self. And so this is the innermost part of you. It's the part of you that God is saying, I want to make you clean on the inside. The Bible says in the book of Jeremiah that the heart is desperately wicked and it's deceitful. Who can know the heart but God? Now, I know a lot of people want to hear sermons only that's going to make you shout. But tonight, we want God to deliver us for real. We want a message that's going to make us look in the mirror and see, Lord, whatever is in my heart that's not like you, God, I want you to search me. I want you to do a cleansing on the inside of me. Lord, show me what I cannot see. Can I tell you all that every man is right in his own eyes? The word of God said that every man is right in his own eyes. So that's why we have to humble ourselves and say, God, I can't wash myself. I can't cleanse my own heart, but I need you, God. I need you to help me, and I need you to search me. I want to share with you all that sometimes God has to show us ourselves, and sometimes it comes by fire. Do you know that sometimes you don't even know what's in you until you get in the midst of a fire? And some of y'all are walking in a fire right now, and a lot of folk don't know about it. But I want to tell you that God will refine you in the midst of the fire. I heard the old saints, they used to say it like this. They would say, Lord, wash me with fuller soap. They would ask God, Lord, wash my heart, wash my mind, wash my soul. Lord, deal with the real core of who I am. Tell your neighbor, I want to be right. Tell somebody else, I want to be right. I want you to know today that it is imperative for us to pray this prayer. Lord, search me. Search my heart, God. Search me. Show me where there is the spirit of unforgiveness still working within me. Let me talk about unforgiveness for a minute. It is the refusal to forgive because of what people have said or done to you. And there are people sitting in the house of God, jumping and shouting, but yet within their hearts, they have a seething, smoldering resentment because of what somebody has done to them. But tonight, I feel the hand of God that's going to go down into the recesses of your soul and break the assignment of unforgiveness that has come in because of deep hurt, because of bitterness, because of rejection. Some of you all are hurting because of what's happening on your job, hurting because of what's happening in your family, hurting. And some of you feel like if I forgive this person, it feels like they're going to get away with what they've done. But you just do what the Bible say. The Bible says when you stand praying, forgive, or your heavenly Father will not, he won't forgive you and he won't hear you. Somebody say, Lord, I want to be right. I want to tell you that there are some people that are dealing with a strong man, a spirit, where the enemy has caused them to go through so many things that they have shut down. The Bible says that the love of many shall wax cold. And I want to share with you all that it is amazing how many people are sitting in God's house and they still have resentment, still have jealousy, still have anger, still have bitterness towards somebody else that's a more talented person. There are some of you that are dealing with the spirit of jealousy. I know you're not going to say amen on it, but jealousy really is born out of insecurity. When you have insecurity on the inside, you begin to measure yourself by somebody else. And then when it looks like they're getting more attention, they're getting more praise, it will make the spirit of rejection make you reject yourself. But tonight we're going after that spirit of self-rejection, low self-esteem. You don't have to be competing with nobody. You don't have to be mad at nobody. You don't have to be jealous with that man's wife and jealous of that woman's husband. You can have what you say. Tell your neighbor, I want to be right. Oh, we need to deal with this assignment that's in the heart. It's got to be pulled out from the root. Saints of God, it's time for an old-fashioned, anointed deliverance service where we have a plain old gully washing, where we stand before God like David did, and we say, God, search me. And don't just search me, but try me. And Lord, if there be any wicked way, I don't know who this is for tonight, but if there be any wicked way, Lord, I want you to take it out. Let me tell you something. Wickedness can come in the form of a smile when you're mad at somebody. And you're still upset and you still haven't dealt with it. And a lot of church folk they should get an Academy Award. Because they can act like it's one thing and they know it's something else. But tonight, I feel the Holy Ghost. I feel the Spirit of God. Even as David said it to the Lord, Lord, search me and try me. Lord, whatever wicked way is in me, Lord, I want you to take it out. Let me tell you something. Every now and then, you have to stop and evaluate where you are. Amen. If you've got unforgiveness in your heart or bitterness, unforgiveness also means I refuse to release you from the punishment that I feel you deserve because of what you've done to me. And so some of you are sitting in the church and you're trying to forgive, but you really want God to get them because of what they did to you. And you can't pray a prayer asking God to get them, because then you turn into a witch sitting right in the church. Come on, somebody. When you're praying and asking God to get them, you turn into a warlock sitting right on the third row. Come on, fourth row, fifth row. You got to let go of the hurt. Let go of the pain. Let go of the bitterness and ask God, Lord, purge it out. Purge it out. Somebody clap your hands and help me say with me. Just say, Lord, I want to be right. Your heart is your moral compass. It's the ability to judge that which is right and that which is wrong. I want to share with you all tonight that some of you have a fretting heart. And so why are you fretting? You're fretting because you kind of feel like the folk that have done you wrong, they're going to get away with it and they're not going to be punished for what they've done. But I came to tell you that the Bible says, fret not thyself because of, Lord have mercy, because of evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the green grass, and they're going to wither. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You don't have to pray, amen, that God gets your enemy. You pray that God bless him. Come on, somebody. Bless them that curse you. Do good to them that despitefully use you. Love them that hate you. Come on, church, to the church of the Lord. Let's give God a mighty praise right there as we ask God, search me. Search me and see if there be any wicked way in me. Prayerlessness is wickedness. To not seek God, amen, is not something that's worthy of praise. We've got to seek the face of God. We've got to pray. Church, it is time for us to come to a place now where we want to get our hearts right. We want to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Church, it seems like in the church world that the emphasis has left Jesus Christ the Messiah. And it seems like people are more interested in people than they are in Jesus Christ. But tonight, with our whole heart, we're going to go after God. And we're going to seek him. We're going to call him. We're going to ask him, Lord, wash me thoroughly and cleanse me from all of my sin. It is time for the Holy Ghost to do an investigation so that there will not be any complicity in your heart. I want to share with you all that many times in the church of the Lord Jesus Christ, we can become cold and stagnant. Let me tell you a spirit that's affecting many, many people in the church today. It's a spirit of distrust. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we don't trust nobody no more. There's a cynical spirit operating in the house of God where people think everybody is a phony, everybody is a fake. The devil is alive. God has a remnant. He has a people that are dedicated to him. Oh, bless his name. I want you all to know that you might be tried in the fire, but the fire is not there to burn you up. It's there to burn out everything not like God. I want you to know that some of your trials, they have not come to break you, but they have come to make you stronger. In the natural, you can't have a real perfume without crushing the roses. If you want some real perfume, there has to be a crushing of the roses. And when you crush it, it brings out the best fragrance. With the olive berry, the best olive oil comes from an olive berry that has been smashed and crushed. And in the midst of the smashing and the crushing, it brings about the best of the olive oil. I came tonight to tell you that some of you are being tried in the fire. You're being crushed. You're in the midst of trials and testings and storm. But God is bringing out the very best of who you are. Search me, Lord. David had gone through a period where, you all know, I won't go into the entire story, but David had sinned a sin against God. And of course, he sinned with a woman by the name of Bathsheba. Amen. You all know that he sinned and had Uriah the Hittite sent to the heat of the battle and had him killed, right? He had him killed. It was a premeditated murder. Where did it come from? It came out of that heart. Church, it is time for us to deal with the reality that God is looking at our hearts. And listen, I know that when we stand before God one day, we want him to say, well done. We want him to say, well done, that good and faithful servant. But in order for us to stand before God in a righteous place, we've got to ask him now, Lord, take it out. Take it out, Lord. Take it out of my heart. What else do we need him to take out? We need God to purge out the spirit of pride. Pride is a higher opinion of oneself than we ought to have. Listen, ain't nobody great but Jesus. And we need to put Jesus back on the marquee. Jesus back on the throne. Jesus back in the light. Come on, somebody. We need to humble ourselves and let Jesus' name ring. He said, if I and I be lifted, I will draw all men unto me. Tell your neighbor, I want to be right. If you want God to search you tonight, I want you, when we get ready to pray, and we're going to have a prayer meeting in a minute, but I want you to be passionate about this request. And say, God, I want you to go down into the very recesses of my soul, into my mind, my will, my emotions. God, take out all of the pride. Take out all of the arrogance. Take out all of the self-promotion. Come on, take out everything that would be an enmity against you. Lord, I want to be clean. I want to be holy. I want to be right. God, take out the wrong attitude. You know, when you got the Holy Ghost will quicken you when you're out of place. Anybody ever had the Holy Ghost to quicken you when you did something wrong? Oh yeah, I want to ask y'all a question. When did you get the Holy Ghost? How long have you had it? Because the real Holy Ghost, when you mistreat somebody, it won't let you rest until you get up and get that thing right in your heart. You know when you're wrong. And the Holy Ghost will tell you, get up and call him and tell him you're sorry. Tell your neighbor, I got the real Holy Ghost. Yeah, that flesh will wrestle with you and tell you, no, don't do that. But when you got the real Holy Ghost, it'll quicken you down on the inside and tell you, go get that right. Church, it's time to stop shouting over things and get stuff right. It's time to get it right. We need to get it right with one another. Amen. I want to tell you that some things are bound in the heart of people. You know, some people just have a wicked heart, a diabolical heart, like Judas had. But I'm telling you tonight, I feel it in the spirit realm. I feel the spirit of deliverance. And some of you, I feel like God is going to break a yoke that's been something that's been just troubling your spirit. But because you got the Holy Ghost, God keeps bringing it to your mind. How many of you want God to search you tonight? Hallelujah. Not only do we want him to search us, we want him to try us, and then we want him to wash us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Praise the name of the Lord. There are times when you need the Lord to reveal to you what's in your heart. Because if you have to judge it for yourself, sometimes you don't realize what's really in there. So tonight we're going to passionately cry out to God and say, God, I want my heart to be right. I want my spirit to be right. Do you know that there are some people in the church that when other people get promoted and other people get lifted up, other people get an opportunity, sometimes they go into almost a depression because they've been waiting on God to open a door or to bless them. And instead of rejoicing with their sister, they've got this thing down on the inside that's working with them that's not right. But tonight, God's going to deal with that part of your heart, that disappointment, that spirit of disappointment because things have not gone the way that you want them to go. I want to be real honest with you all. It's a lot of bitter church people in the house of God. Some of them are disappointed because God didn't answer what they wanted. Ah, God, who is it in here? I feel it in my spirit. Some have been disappointed even by the Father because he didn't do what you asked him to do. I want to teach you a lesson tonight, and that is that you've got to respect the sovereign will of God. Those of you that prayed that God would save somebody's life and they died, I want to talk to you for a minute. I want you to know that God had the boundaries set. And you got to learn how to humbly submit and bow down to the will of God. Even though you might have prayed a prayer and God didn't answer it, some people are upset because they did not get the prayer answered that they believed God for. But do you believe that sometimes God have to snatch folk out of the earth because some things are coming down the pike that they may not be able to deal with? Y'all ain't saying nothing. God is sovereign. He is holy. So if your mother died or your father died, stop being angry with God and say, the Lord giveth and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Can I get y'all to clap right there? Tell the Lord, Lord, I want to be right. I want you to dig deep tonight and let's get to the root. Let's get to the core. Let's get to the basis of what is hindering your walk with God. I want to tell you that there are some saved people that have unsaved family members and they're still not saved, and you have prayed and prayed and prayed and you keep trying to witness and you keep trying to win them to Christ and they still don't have a mind. I want to tell you, listen, sometimes you got to take your hands off of it and give it to God and ask the Lord, Lord, send workers out of the vineyard. Send laborers out of the vineyard to minister to my son, to minister to my daughter. And then you got to just trust God. Lord, I put them in your hands and I'm going to give you the praise. In everything, you've got to give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. How many of you want the Lord to search your heart tonight? Do you want him to try you? Do you want him to see if there be any wicked way and then to lead you everlasting? Church of God, it is time today for us to come to a place in our spirit, amen, that we get God's attention. And the way you're going to get his attention is by your humility and by your honesty. You cannot be delivered if you won't be honest. You cannot be delivered if you won't tell the truth about what's really going on in your heart. Yes, I know we can jump. Yes, I know we can shout. Yes, I know we can praise. But every now and then, in a time of convocation, in a time of coming together, in a time where God is getting our attention, he's commanding us to deal with our hearts. Come on, talk to me in here. Some of us need to be delivered. There's a strong spirit of lust that hits the church. And the pastor is preaching and telling you what's right, what is wrong. But there are some people that because of the lust in their heart, they'll lust after another man's wife and try to pursue another person's husband. Come on, somebody. There's a spirit even happening in some women that are so ready. ready to get married, and because they have waited and waited and waited, sometimes the enemy will try to strike their mind and say, what's the use of waiting? Oh, Lord, have mercy. But I'll tell you this, it pays to wait on God. It pays to wait on God. I know it's not pretty, but this is what's happening in the household of God. And somebody got to speak to it and tell that woman, I don't care how tight you pull your belt, you're still not going to get him. I don't care how you grin and skin in his face. God has given a man of God the spirit of Jehu for Jezebel. Oh, come on, talk to me in here. Wait on the Lord. He'll strengthen your heart. We got to get rid of the pride. Have we said a few things we got to get rid of? I want y'all to help me preach it. We got to get rid of the pride. Come on. The anger. We got to get rid of unforgiveness. We got to deal with the spirit of bitterness. We got to deal with the spirit of disappointment. Come on. We got to get rid of whatever the enemy is trying to utilize in our lives to keep us out of the will of God. Y'all clap your hands if you want to be delivered. Look at your neighbor. Tell them, I want to be right. I want to be right. I heard an old songwriter say it like this. He said, search me, Lord, and turn on the light from heaven on my soul. If you find anything that shouldn't be, he said, take it out, Lord, and strengthen me because I want to be right. I want to talk to people tonight that's got a I want to be right anointing. I want to walk right. I want to talk right. I want to live right. I want to live holy. I want to be right. Can I just ask the I want to be right people to clap your hands? Oh, you're not clapping like you want to be right. Do you want to be saved? After it's all over, I don't want to just stand before God and not hear him say, well done. But he said, some are you going to say, did not I prophesy in your name? Did not I cast out devils in your name? And he's going to say, I never knew you. Ye worker of iniquity, depart from me. Come on, I don't want to be a preacher and then be a castaway and in that great day. But tell your neighbor, I want to be right. I want to be saved. And I want to be whole. If you want to be right one more time, put your hands together. I need you to put your hands together real strong. I feel God searching somebody tonight. I feel him trying somebody tonight. Can I hear you clap your hands and say, Lord, I want to be right. I want to be saved. And I want to be whole. I want you to know that God is going to be to you whatever you need. And tonight, I can't tell you what's in your heart, but you can actually identify what's really going on in yourself. You know your heart knows what's happening in you. And so tonight I want to ask you, as we get ready to pray in just a little while, I want you to pray and go after God tonight with a great passion. As a deer pant after the water brooks, so doth my soul pant after thee, O God. In a dry and a thirsty land where no water is, I want to see your power as I have seen it in the sanctuary. Because thy loving kindness is better than life, my lips shall praise you. Is anybody panting after God? Does anybody need God to touch you? Need God to cleanse you, to wash you, to purify you? I want to talk to some mature saints that's serious about the Lord right now. Are you serious about the Lord? Are you ready to go after God? I want to thank God for a minute for altar calls, because when we came up as young people in the church, the altar was not just a place where we would come to get saved, but the old saints would call us up when we needed a touch from God. And every now and then, the mothers would just tell you to come on to the altar and let's go before God and ask the Lord to touch us tonight. They would tell us to tarry in the Holy Ghost. We're in a time now where we need to call on the name of the Lord, the name that is a strong tower where the righteous run into it and they are safe. We need to call on the name of the Lord because Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. How many of you know about the altar call? I remember we would go to the altar, and when the mothers would feel something in their spirit, they would say, it's something up here that ain't right. How many of y'all remember those days when they would say, it's something up here that ain't right? And they would tell us to repent and to cry out to God and say, Lord, forgive me for whatever I've done that's not like you. Well, that's what I feel in my soul tonight. I feel a passionate cry asking God, Lord, do it again for me. Lord, take me back to my first love. God, I've gotten so distracted because of all that's going on in my life. But Lord, I want you to revive me again and restore me again and sanctify me again and wash my mind, God. Wash my heart, Lord. Search me and try me. If there be any wicked way in me, God, I want you to take it out. Take it out of my thoughts, God. Take it out of my heart. Take it out of my soul. Look at your neighbor, tell him, I want to be right. I want to be right. When you really want to be right, God will purify you. He will sanctify you. He will cleanse you from all unrighteousness. I feel it in my spirit tonight that somebody's spirit is saying, Pastor Kim, that's me. I want God to do something down on the inside. I want him to roll me in the floor again. I want him to baptize me with fire. I want him to take me over. I want my hands to go up. I want my feet to get lighter. I want him to restore my joy. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. I want him to touch me again. I want him to touch me until I know that I've been changed. Do I have any believers tonight? Because God is. He's the joy and the strength of our lives. He moves all pain, all the misery, and all of the strife. He promised to keep me, never to leave me. He never, never comes short of his word. I've got to fast and pray and stay in the narrow way. And I've got to keep my life clean every day. I want to go with him when he comes back. I've come too far and I'll never turn back. God is. He's my everything. He's my joy in sorrow. He's my light in darkness. He's my all in all. He is my today and my tomorrow. He's everything that I ever needed. Listen, whatever you're searching for, you can find it in Jesus Christ. I feel this in my spirit tonight. I feel a desire to get to God, a desire to reach out for him. I feel a desire for real deliverance, a desire saying, God, Lord, whatever it takes, Lord, wash me. Whatever it takes, Lord, cleanse me and purify me. And if you're one of those Christians that feel like I don't need that, I'm sorry. You're in a dangerous place when you can't feel God and you don't need him to touch you. You're in a dangerous place when the passion for God is gone. That's why he's telling us tonight, ask him to search me. Search me and try me. I want to tell you all that as an evangelist, as a preacher, I'm not interested in being the most popular. I'm not interested in being the most visible. But I want to be a vessel that will say what thus saith the Lord. If they like it, I'm going to say it. If they don't like it, I'm going to say it. I'm going to set my face as a flint and say what thus saith the Lord. And I hear God calling his church back to their knees, back to consecration, back to prayer. But I feel some folk that's ready to run after it. If that's you tonight, say, God, I'm running after it tonight because I want to be right. I remember my mother teaching my sisters and I when we were young. Mama would wake us up at 5 a.m, Bishop. And she would tell us before we would get up and go to school, she would tell us, girls, let's go before the Lord in prayer. And Mama would teach us how to get down on our knees. And she taught each of us how to pray and talk to the Lord. And Mama told us one day, she said, listen, you don't have no time to be cute. If you want something from God, you got to go after it. You got to call him with all of your might. And and with all of your strength. You can't be mediocre talking to God. But if you want something from him, mama said you got to call him from your belly. Anybody in here know what I'm talking about? In fact, let me just test the waters. Let me hear you just say, oh, out of your belly. This is a travailing church. I heard something. If you want something from God tonight, let me hear you say, oh, God. Oh, ba-ba-ba, shanta. I feel the Holy Ghost turning in your belly. I feel God watching you. I feel him touching you right now. But you got to be real with God. You got to go after him with all of your heart, all of your mind, all of your strength. Let me hear you cry one more time. Oh, God. When we call him tonight, we're calling on the King of Kings. We're calling on Emmanuel. We're calling on the elect of God. We're calling on the horn of our salvation, the captain of our souls, the chief shepherd, the cornerstone and the redeemer. When you call him, don't just call him from here, but you got to cry from your belly. Why are we crying from our belly? Because the Bible said that out of your belly, rivers. Rivers of living water shall flow. I felt somebody that's got a deep root of the Holy Ghost in your belly. I just heard somebody holler in the Holy Ghost. Somebody just holler. Hallelujah. Well, I want to take you all together in this time of prayer. And I want to share with you all that in times of prayer and intercession, that this is what God gave me, to tell his people to cry out to him and to ask him to search you and to try you. If there be any wicked way in you, to take it out. Can't nobody wash you like God can. Can't nobody cleanse you like the Lord can. So can I just see the hands of you that want to participate in this prayer? Hallelujah, because we're going somewhere with it. Are y'all all right? Repeat after me, Father God, I thank you for your anointing. I thank you that your name calms the storm. I thank you that you are my redeemer. And today, in the name of Jesus, Father, show me myself the way that you see me. Father, I come to you now and I repent for everything that is not like God. Lord, take it out of my heart. Take out the pride, the higher opinion. Take out the anger. Take out the bitterness. Take out the smoldering resentment that's been hidden down in my heart. In the name of Jesus, take out all lust. Take out all fear. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I ask you tonight to wash my heart. You said, guard your heart, for out of it are the issues of life. And right now, Lord, as an act of my faith, I humble myself and I lift up my voice in repentance. And I ask you for cleansing and I ask you for deliverance in the name of Jesus. Come on, put your hand on your head right now. Put your hand on your head. Say, Father God, I apply and appropriate the precious blood of Jesus, the blood in my mind, the blood in my will, the blood in my emotions. Lord, heal me from everything that's affecting my life. And wash me, Lord. Cleanse me, God. Search me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And I'll give you the glory and I'll give you the praise. In the name of Jesus, purify my heart. Purify my soul, God. My mind, my will, and my emotions. In the name of Jesus. And say this with me. Say, the blood of Jesus, I drive out every assignment over my life. I drive it out of my heart. I drive it out of my mind. In the name of Jesus, I take authority over unforgiveness, over all bitterness, over all deep hurts, over all rejection. In the name of Jesus, every hindering spirit, every delaying tactic, I give up all the ground. And I thank you, Lord, for the power of deliverance in the name of Jesus. Put your hands together right there while we're praying. In the name of Jesus. Come on, say it with me. Say, Lord, I forgive every person that has disappointed me, that has hurt me, that has harmed me. I give up the ground of unforgiveness. I command it to leave me now in the name of Jesus. Lord, take out the wounds of the wounded spirit and the broken heart in the name of Jesus. Now wash me, Lord. Now cleanse me, Father, in Jesus' name. God, I want to be right. Show me what's in there. Show it to me, God, so that I can repent, Father, and get it right. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, for washing me, for cleansing me, and for delivering me tonight. In the name of Jesus. Somebody clap your hands. I feel God washing somebody. I feel God purging somebody. I feel Him touching you right now. Somebody stand on your feet right now. Stand up. And this is what I want to ask you to do. I want you all to spread out for a minute. Just leave your seat. Spread out for a minute. Everybody in the room, spread out, spread out. And here's what I hear in the Holy Ghost. I want you to identify the cry that you have. If it's search me, if it's try me, if it's wash me, if it's purge me, if it's deliver me, if it's cleanse me. Whatever that cry is right now, I want you to identify it. If it's search me, God, what is your cry? What is it? Tell me what it is. Tell me. Somebody said purge me. Somebody said wash me. Come on, come on. Tell me what your cry is. Touch me, cleanse me, wash me, heal me. Glory to God. Y'all come closer, come closer, come closer. Lift your hands up before God. And I want you to lift your hands just before we begin any music. Lift your hands, everybody. And between you and God, listen, saints, don't be mediocre in this cry. But I hear the Holy Ghost say, cry. Cry with passion. Cry with intensity. Cry with fervor. It is the fervent, effectual prayers of a righteous man that availeth much. And I hear the sound of a cry. God has honored this convocation. He has honored the fasting. He has honored the prayer. And He said, I'm going to wash you tonight. Come on, lift your hands and let me hear you cry. Come on. Come on, tell Him, wash me, Lord. Cleanse my heart, God. Lord, I need you. Lord, I repent before you. God, I call on you tonight. Search me, Lord. Take it out, God. Take out everything not like you. Come on, church, let me hear you cry. Say, out of your belly. Oh, yeah, da 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 da
Come on, you gotta open your mouth. Come on, open your mouth. Yeah, I feel God. I said I feel God. That's it, sister. Throw your head back and cry. Help us, God. Search us, Lord. Cleanse us, Father. Purify us. The preachers need to cry. The evangelists need to cry. The leaders need to cry. The church mothers cry. Trustees cry. Musicians cry out. Touch us, God. If you got the Holy Ghost, I need you to go deep down in the recesses of your soul and cry, God, wash this heart. I can't cleanse my own heart. I can't wash myself. Purge me, Lord. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Come on, young people. Tell them to wash me, Lord. Wash me, God. I feel God passing by. I feel like the woman with the issue of blood. Ah, she reached out and touched Jesus. Reach out and touch him. God is touching the evangelist. He's touching the preachers. He's renewing your strength. He's some of you have been hurt by your members, hurt by betrayal, hurt by folk that have lied on you. You got to forgive tonight. I hear a cry in Ohio. I hear a cry. I need you to go deep down in your belly and say, oh, God. Oh, yeah, ta 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 da 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 da. Lay your hand in your belly. Lay your hand on your belly. You may not understand it with your natural mind, but God is purifying you. Come on, teachers. Come on, preachers. God is saying, tell them to search me. Search my mind. Search my heart. Search me, God. Purge me tonight. Purify me tonight. Cleanse me tonight. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, for one more minute. If you got the Holy Ghost, there's a washing, there's a cleansing, there's a deliverance, there's a gully washing, there's a purifying. I feel God on that brother. I feel God in this pulpit. I said, I feel God in this pulpit. Come on, church, for about two more minutes, do this with me. Throw your head back and say, oh, God. Come on, say, oh, God. Come on, come on. I hear the sound of travail. Say, oh, God. We call on you tonight. We're your intercessors, and we are your people, and we're crying that you will wash us tonight. We're crying that you will cleanse us tonight. We're crying that you will purify us. Take it out, Lord. Every wrong spirit, every wrong attitude, give us back a praying spirit. Give us back our consecration. Take us back to our first love, that we would seek you like we used to seek you. God, stir up your anointing. God, stir up your fire. God, stir up the power of the Holy Ghost. God, heal us tonight. Deliver us tonight. We need your help. Somebody say, help, Lord. Help us. Oh, yeah, Baba Boshaya. Come on, cry out to him. Come on, cry out to him. Ask the Holy Ghost, which is our paraclete. He is our helper. Ask him to help us tonight. Somebody say, help me, Lord. Help me, Jesus. I hear the sound of strong intercession in this church, in this meeting. God is depositing a new level of prayer, a new level of intercession. I need the prayer warriors in this room to rise up with your voice and say, oh, Jesus. Come on, call him for 1 minute. Oh, Jesus. Jesus, we need you tonight. We're going back to our knees. We're calling you. We're calling on you. We need a deliverance. We need a revival. We need a breakthrough. We won't stop praying until we get delivered. Jesus, thou son of David, seed of Abraham. Jesus, you have anointed this convocation. You have anointed this people. So now we call you. Glory to God. Listen, get somebody near you and just get one person. Put your hand in their hand. Come on, come on. Ibashata. Put their hand up high in the air like you're giving them a high five. And I want you to start praying for that person. Come on, ask God to purify. Ask God to give them what they need. Ask God to give them what they're looking for. Ask God to give them a word. Ask God to purify their heart. In the name of Jesus, God, we want you to search us like you did David. Search us and try us. Hear the voice of our supplication. Hear us tonight. God, you're our strength. You are our shield. Our heart trusts in you, and we are helped. Lord, we call you just like the psalmist. You're our rock and our fortress in a weary land. Jesus, I wish there were some Jesus callers. Jesus, we call you in Ohio. We forget about ourselves. We forget about our problems. We forget about our storm. And we call you with humility. We call you with sincerity. We call you. God, we need you. We can't make it without you. With your neighbor, get a breakthrough. Come on, call him, tell him, wash us again, purify us again, take us back to our first love. Yes, yes, Lord, yes, Jesus, take us back to fasting and prayer. Take your church back, Lord. This is your convocation, Lord. This is a gathering of the eagles, Lord. This is a gathering of the saints, Lord. We're calling out to you, we're crying out to you, Lord. Do it again. Baptize us, baptize us, renew us, purify us, Jesus. We know that there's power in your name, there's deliverance in your name, there's healing in your name. Touch us again, baptize us again, renew us again. Come on, speak. Speak in your heavenly language. Come on, speak. I need all of the preachers over there that's over in this corner to come stand across here. Come quickly. Oh, yeah, yes, come, come, come. You too, young man. Stand across here. Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, yeah, la, 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 la. Lift your hands up. There's power. There's a cleansing. There's a deliverance. My God, I feel purity. I feel holiness. I feel God elevating. Come on. Come on. Cry out of your belly. There's a woman in purple. Tell her to come here. Rabasata. Come on, church. Cry out to him. Cry out to him. Cry out to him. Hey, Shata. Hida ba 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 ba. Hida ba ha. Hoba Shanda. Hey, 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 hey. Hida da. Yes, God. Yes, God. Somebody clap your hands out there. Don't stop calling his name. Hallelujah. One more time. Get another partner and give him a high five. Come on, move quickly. Now this prayer is a prayer to stir up the gifts, to stir up the fire, to stir up the anointing. You've been preached to. You've been prophesied to. It's already in your belly. You've got anointed men of God that have already spoken prophetically. Now it's time to stir it up. Get you one prayer partner and touch them in their hand. And y'all go for broke. You're praying that God will stir up your gift. Stir up your prayer. Stir it up, Lord. Stir it up, God. Stir it up, Lord. Stir it up, God. Come on, church, cry out. Come on, cry out. Come on, cry out. Cry out, yeah, yeah. Cry out. Lord, I thank you for deliverance. Shanda ba 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 ba. He da da da, but the residue, huh? The residue. Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on, come on. I feel a cry in this church. I have not heard this sound in a very long time, but I hear the church in Ohio lift your voice to God and cry. Oh, yeah. Oh, Bashe. He da 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 da. Come on, come on, come on. Deliverance is locked up in your cry. Your breakthrough is locked up in your cry. Your power is locked up in your cry. Come on, hiya, 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 hiya. Healing, shanda la 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 la. Deliverance, hiya la la bosata. Yay! The spirit of prayer is going to change your life, son. Hiya la 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 basanda. The spirit of prayer. It's going to get on these young men, and they're going to start praying in here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I feel one more assignment. I feel one more assignment. I want you to lock arms with about three people that's near you. Just put your arm in their arm for a minute. And this is what I feel God doing. I feel strength coming. Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. I feel strength coming. I feel strength coming. I feel strength coming. Some of you have been working in the church for years. I feel strength coming. Receive strength right now. Begin to pray for one another. Ask God to encourage your brother. Encourage your sister. Loose the strength of God. He called up baby Osiah. He called up Bossa. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. He double shut up. Oh, Baba, Baba, Bossiah. He called up strength. Oh, Bossiah. Deliverance and strength. He called up Bossiah. Not by might, not by power, but by my spirit. Saith the Lord God. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. There's strength coming. There's strength coming. Oh, yeah, la 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 shut up. La 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 shut up. It's a new day. Lord, do it. Lord, do it. Do it, Lord. La 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 shut up. Do it, God. Fix it, Lord. I feel a revival coming with the young people. The young people in this church, I feel a brokenness and an anointing. Hey, you're a leader. You're a leader, young lady. You're a leader. Ah, lead for Jesus. Just come walk with me. The hand of the Lord shall rest on this child. In the name of Jesus, lift your hands and give him praise. Glory to God. Before you take your seat, yes. Yes, Lord. Before you take your seat, I want you to be a vessel. Man of God, whatever you ask God to do, he's going to do it. Just ask him. You got the heart of God, man of God. Do this for me. I know we've been crying out to God, and we've been calling on the name of Jesus. But would you just do me a favor? I want you to go to about four people. This is a specific assignment. I want you to go to people that's been faithful. It's been dedicated. They have served in the house of God. I want you to go to at least four people and tell them that it's not in vain. Can you just be obedient? Go find seven people. Look them in the eye. Look them in their eye. Look them in their eye. Tell them God's going to honor your service. He's going to honor it. He's going to honor it. He's going to honor it. I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you care for me in such a special way. Come on, go find four more people. Tell them I want my heart to be right, and I love you. I love you, my brothers. I love you, my sisters.
Thank you for joining us for Holy Convocation 2019. And we pray that you have been richly blessed by every word that has come forth.